bills. Say what? Here we go. Can y'all really feel it? Baby girl. Can you feel us?
Cold fresh air. Feel the melody that's in the air. Oh yeah. I'm about to take a look around.
Hustle TV with the NOM Show with the legendary Bomb Squad member, Keith Shockley. What's going on, brother?
Pleasure, man.
Pleasure.
Pleasure to have you here.
Yeah. You know? Man, what's going on today, man, with the music, man?
Well, right now, I'm doing some things with PV, and we just debuted this brand new Dark Matter speaker. It's reasonably priced for the up-and-coming mobile DJ.
Right.
And so this is the thing we're doing. We're trying to build a mobile DJ set.
Okay.
It's all powered. And then you can have your own presets.
What?
So it's kind of crazy. Yeah. Yeah, so it's kind of crazy because now when you get into places,
It
becomes like I'm always having trouble adjusting. And the thing about power speakers,
right,
it's like you are stuck with what it is.
Yes.
And then some people always tell you, well, you can just run if you DJ, if you got a controller, You can just run straight out of the controller into there. But the problem is your controller becomes your EQ, and you don't want that because you're doing your things with your records.
Yeah, you're going to twist it up.
Yeah, you're going to twist it up. This here, you can go straight into there and then set your EQ settings on whether you want more bass, lower, or more treble, EDM, or some old school hip hop, and then store it, and then you're good.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So now you got your own setting. Trust me, I'm going to have some Keith Shockley settings in there. That's going to be
You should.
You know, gotta have that, like that 808 knock. That 808 knock is gonna kill you.
Now, I'm a DJ. I DJ for All Hip Hop, Hustle TV, and I recently did a mix for All Hip Hop, and I put Ice Cube's whole album cover that you helped produce that made it to number one in the nation.
Yeah.
Man, they say Keep it, so I'm like, what? I'm like, wow. So I want to say thank you for saving the West Coast hip hop.
Oh man, come on, man. Listen, like we all had love for East Coast and West Coast.
Right.
And I was always a huge fan of NWA, DJ Quick. I didn't go on, you know what I'm saying? My Felly Fellum, I've been huge fans of those guys.
Right.
So when Ice Cube was looking to do his project, man, he came over to the East Coast, ran into Chuck at Def Jam, and said, yo, I got a project you can get on, was a Burn Hollywood Burn.
Right.
And then from then, he's just like, yo, why don't you just do my album?
Yeah.
I was like, cool. Ice Cube came out to Long Island, camped out with us for about 2 months.
Man, it's phenomenal,
crazy.
Man.
That's crazy.
And I thank you, man. So I know he thanked you, too.
Oh, yeah.
He's my favorite rapper. Yeah. So when I heard that, I'm like, oh, he's in. Yeah. So I'm like, man, it's a wonderful
thing. That's my man. We still kick it, man. It's kind of good.
It's all good. And I'm so happy that you're a part of this, man. It makes the DJ give more thankful for you.
Yeah, well, you got to understand. Start out as DJs.
Yeah.
So, and I keep telling the history. We started out using, I got a picture of me from 1975 using the PV guitar amp, and we had the column speakers.
Yeah.
So, the PV column speakers.
The big horns
with that. Had the four speakers in PV, and then we had the guitar amp, because you got to understand, 74.
Right.
It's primitive, man. that shit was like horse and carriage. It was horse and carriage records back then. DJing, you know, no headphones, no cue.
Right.
You had to, like, you know.
Yeah,
it's evolved now.
Yeah,
it's evolved. Right. So, I'm grateful to be around long enough to see the whole DJ game evolve into that. Because like you guys said, P.E., we're DJs first before records. So that you ain't taking from us.
No.
And so this is what we're DJs, and we was definitely sound technicians. Because back then, you had to have a mobile sound. You had to have that shit. You
know, yeah, cracking.
You had to crack it. You couldn't, because if it wasn't cracking, you know,
y'all was
the hood was like, yo, he don't need that. We taking it. So,
man, thank you so much, man.
Pleasure,
for the history lesson for everybody out there, man. Keith Shockley, man, Bomb Squad, Hustle TV at the NOM Show. Come out and check him out, man. It's going to be off the hook tomorrow, man. This is the preview, and it's the legend right here, man. Thank you so much.
Yo, it's Keith Shockley, legendary Public Enemy, Bomb Squad, here with PV for Hustle TV. Y'all keep your hustle on. You know what I'm saying? DJ's in the house. Peace.
That's
me.
Oh, I love this. Oh, hold on, boy.
Man, this is history right here.
Come on, man.
I don't know. I was like trying to figure out some jokes. Come on, what's happening, man? This is my man right here.
Y'all
got to
get a picture of this legendary status.
Yeah.
Right?
Here we are.
What's up?
I'm George. Sorry, baby.
This guy, man, told me everything I know. Man.
I'm going to just go back to work.
Man. I'm ready, man. Yeah. I'm ready.
Nobody do that to me.
I know.
And I gave you permission.
I got it. I'm ready. Man, I'm
both
ready.
Of them. Both of them are like legendary. Atomic Dog.
I know that.
Yeah. Peace, chocolate, you know what I mean? Look, look, you've been sampled so much by everybody in the world. This dude here.
Oh, trust me, I know who.
I
know. Trust me, the mob, I know. They know how to do it.
Dog,
they know. All that pee shit.
Yeah, this is the man.
That's the way you use samples.
Yes. There you go.
See, some people loop, but then some people make arrangements.
There you go. You pretty much put it blocked off.
Okay.
I can't say no more, man. He's like, this guy.
You can write the script.
Right.
You know, the charts after he finished with it.
Yeah.
Okay, you can say that.
You can write it out.
You know what that says? I'm just so honored. This like, this guy, man. This guy.
Dick on my
You know what I mean? I mean, P-Funk, meets funk and rap. I mean, your legacy, man.
It's just the beginning. They trying to end it, but it's just starting. That's why y'all
got
to come back and do that shit some more.
Got it, man.
Come to the catalog. You ain't got to worry about getting sued.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because that's where it need to be, where you can do it with any record. You sample it the way you want and don't worry about that bullshit.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
That's what they trying to kill it by.
They're trying to kill it because now the sampling fees and laws is
they're
like,
to kill it.
Yeah, man, like, come on, man.
We'll make a deal with that. Feasible for both of us.
There we go.
You can get in the catalog and have a ball.
But look, you were ahead of time.
This is music.
You were ahead of your time. You were ahead of your time. And you guys made history again.
We'll bump heads and just keep on going.
Bump heads. That's why I peeped around the corner. I said, wait, that's my man sitting there. You know?
That's very status, man.
Let's start this shit again for real, because it ain't going nowhere.
It ain't going nowhere. Nah,
they just fuck it up in the courts.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
They fuck it up so bad in the courts.
No, they're trying to stop it. That's all it is.
And then everybody, what happens is, when they stop it and you got to go to the courts and pay these astronomical fees, your creativity gets a little.
Yeah. No, but we call it stem cells. TV, they do their hustle on. They got their hustle on, y'all. Hustle TV, they do the dog, y'all.
That's what it is, man. Thank you so much, brother. Appreciate you.